Good morning. You've seen some amazing things yesterday, I hope, and you're going to see more amazing things today. And I'm going to spend just a couple of minutes telling you how we managed to do that at a government agency. It is really important to match your culture to your mission. So if you are, for example, a large chemical corporation with processes that are up 24/7, that are complicated, that need to stay in control, a risk-averse culture will work for you. But if you are supposed to do high-risk, high-impact research, to do things that other people can't do, to give yourself the freedom to think completely outside the box, you want the opposite of that culture. You want a risk-embracing culture. Neither culture is right or wrong. It's about the match of the culture to the mission. And at RPE, we all share the same mission. So here's a little bit what it's like. I am so impressed that even though we're a young and small agency of 10 years, it's pretty startup-esque, especially for the federal government. We all come in with term limits between 3 and 5 years, and then we have to leave and find another job. We're an extraordinarily flat and lean organization. Not a lot of middle managers. We do everything with about 60 feds, which is pretty incredible when you look at the scope of what we've done. A key is diversity. We have diversities of opinion, styles, institutions where people come from, personalities. I mean, the worst thing you can have is a team of people that are all exactly like yourself. Because how is that useful? You already have your own brain. We want as many different brains as we can get. And I think one of the key attributes of people that come to RPE is that they like to learn. It is one of the best things. I mean, if you're like me, you're like a semiconductor materials person, and you're sitting in somebody's pitch session where they're talking about agriculture, that's pretty cool. You're learning stuff every day. The people that come to RPE are comfortable with risk and ambiguity. The term limits sort of self-select for that. We are not competitive. We have enough money. That's not the issue. We are extremely collaborative. I have never been in any sort of a group that was as collaborative as we are. We all vet each other's pitches. We all talk to each other. And we will challenge each other, but it's not from a point of negativity. Because, you know, we don't have, you know, ratings. We don't win when somebody else loses. We want everybody to win, because then we follow our mission and the agency wins. So we truly are collaborative. We're also very independent and self-managing. Note that thing about the very lean organization. So this means you might not have a lot of the support that you might have had earlier in your career. It is a federal job. Federal jobs don't really come with perks. So you are not coming for the perks. You're coming to make an impact. You're coming because you have a passion for innovation. And that's really who we're looking for. I'm going to give you one quick note of what it's like. So we go through this pitch process where people have an idea of what they might want to do. Because what we do is we choose the problems that need to be solved. How to solve them are our performers. We're the ones who decide what needs to be solved. What does that solution need to look like? That's a very sort of different skill set. So we go through a few different rounds of this. We have workshops and pre-pitches and things like that. So when we finally pitch to the agency, we're pitching to all the other program directors, tech to market folks, fellows. We have a 20-minute grace period where nobody is allowed to ask a question for 20 minutes. And at the end of that 20 minutes, some people's heads look like they're about to explode. But we honor the 20 minutes. And then you will hear the most amazing group of feedback and questions, and it really helps you dig into the problem that needs to be solved and why. And it really comes down to this. The fact that we're trusted, and therefore we have the freedom to solve the problems in the way that we know that they need to be solved. This is a really rare thing. This is why RPE works. We have program directors, tech to market folks, and fellows. You can see more on our website. If this is you, feel free to apply. If this isn't you, that's not a bad thing. Let people who you think are a fit apply. And I just want to say this was us last year at our last summit. There's already some faces, of course, who are gone because of our term limits. That's sort of bittersweet. But their impact lives on in their programs. And that is something that I think is incredibly special. People come here because they have a passion for innovation and impact. And our first keynote speaker this morning could not embody that better. His company, DECA Research and Development Corporation, has developed all sorts of things, from personal mobility devices like the iBot wheelchair, and maybe you've heard of the Segway, to many different kinds of medical devices, novel Stirling engines, et cetera, et cetera. But honestly, I think one of the most impressive things that he's done, he's co-founded FIRST, which I think has been around for about 30 years now, which engages young people into science and technology. But it doesn't just engage them, it teaches them how to be collaborative, leadership, the skills you need to succeed. So I couldn't be more pleased this morning to welcome Mr. Dean Kamen to the stage.